Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to another video. Today we are back with another franchise draft video. Now I did put some people on the trade block that weren't really important people that we could trade for. So yeah, do got some trade offers here. You have received one or more trade offers. So these are actually the people who we put trade offers on. But we would get these people for, I think, her backup tight end. Maybe our starter. Let's see our lineup here. Yeah. We got T. Hawkins. So now the next video of my YouTube channel is gonna be a bit complicated because I got a lot of stuff ahead of me. But yes, that is our backup, and we do get J. Coleman and T. Hill. I'm going to accept that. Yes. First off, you get she watches. First off, we are getting another tight end. Now we have whoever this is. Got Taysom Hill. And we got a corner. And we got Justin Coleman. So, yeah. I think our fullback on the trading block. And then we have for David Montgomery. Now, David Montgomery is our backup running back. Remember that. So, I'm deciding to get to hit this trade. We get Juju Smith-Schuster, which is a pretty good running back. I would say he's probably I kind of would say he's a little overrated, but not that much. And we get K. Johnson, which I don't know who he is. We also have these, and they did. I think they sent us like, so yeah, just be aware of that. I'm probably not look for some more trade offers, but yeah, let's play our next game. Oh shoot, guys. Can't forget. We are going to put. We have to cut one player already.
Here are some recommendations to get you started.
Oh yeah. Don't forget. Don't forget, guys. We are So we are on all pro, which that with if I go one more, that's all Madden. We're gonna be on all Madden for this game, and we're gonna see how it does for us. We are versing the Panthers. We are versing the Panthers. So hopefully we can get a dub this game. So our best players are Derrick Henry, Aaron Rodgers, and Fletcher Cox. So yeah, I am gonna try to get Aaron Donald. No, I'm just joking. I'll never be able to get him. Well, probably not, at least.
From MetLife Stadium in New Jersey.
So here we go. Waiter the Tater. Second game. Let's get this.
Two teams here, each off to 1-0 starts as this one is underway on EA Sports.
We beat the Titans last game, which actually the Giants did beat the Titans in real life, so that's a big L for the Titans.
And he said he was feeling good in the lead up to the season, and he proved it in a big way in week one with four touchdown passes. Had the offense moving at peak efficiency right at the start.
We had a lot of stuff happen last week. In real life, we had the Bengals lose to the Steelers week one. In that game, they probably missed about 20 field goal kicks, probably, if I was counting right. I did watch the game. It was insane. But, yeah. Poor Bengals. Hopefully, I want them to start off with an 0-2 season, but we just let the Carolina Panthers score a touchdown right on us, like the first play in the game. I can't say crap now.
And the Panthers need just two plays on their opening drive to take the early lead.
So yeah.
Heck of a start to his season. He had two touchdowns in the opener last week. Another one here in week two.
The touchdown machine. This okay. Early, but sometimes you get okay. So in, you know, we're not talking about the game right now. But in my perspective, I think the Bengals are overrated. Like he was shot out of a cannon. They're too. I think they're overrated. I think everybody thinks they're like wet. They're like. I think everybody thinks they're like. Oh my goodness! They're gonna go undefeated. They're gonna win the Super Bowl this year. Since they almost beat the Rams in the Super Bowl, but big boy Aaron Donald came in.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
I can't hear you.
Returns this to the 22.
Also, I'm talking to someone who likes the Bengals. That's mostly why I want the Bengals to go 0-2 starting off their season. So. See what T. Higgins. Oh, what a grab! What a grab! Well, Aaron North. Right, DeAndre Hopkins. Right here. DeAndre Hopkins. Roll out. Run! Yes! Okay, we looking for T. Higgins. I keep on saying T. Higgins. T. Higgins, but what I'm used to.
Comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
That, I know, that almost was a very bad.
How imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their
ah, you didn't get it. We're going for it. Time on the scramble and now fourth down. Gonna make the timeout because I accidentally clicked.
They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
But yeah, we're gonna go for it. Derrick Henry can truck some kids up in here. So
they'll run, it's Henry.
Oh yeah!
First before he's taken down at the third.
Oh yeah, Henry. Power drive in there, why don't you? This play looks interesting. Oh! Go! That's face mask. That's almost a face mask.
It's a gain of 11 and a giant first down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. A first down carry for Henry. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Maybe this is how we win games. We just run it. And
week one, and they were able to get that road victory in the opener. Now they look to get to 2-0 in front of the home crowd.
And look, any road win in the NFL, that's huge. But when you do it week one, that gets you pointed in the right direction and sends notice to the rest of the league.
Be moving the ball. So from come on. Who's at 68? Come on.
At the 38.
Oh yeah, wonderful block. Truck him. Let's go. Attaboy, Derrick Henry. That's how you get first downs. You just truck people.
Again, it's Henry. And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry.
I will say we have the best QB, right now.
I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total.
I accidentally unplugged my mic.
Receivers downfield also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
Give him 4 on the carry and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Let's go Beasley. Looking for Beasley right here. Maybe Hawkinson.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers.
Oh boy. Oh boy. T. Higgins! Get him!
And he is not quite.
Yes! 1 yard run! 1 yard run! That's why. Oh my gosh.
From another team.
See?
No one wants just fall on in football anymore, do they? They want to take it and try and score themselves.
But when you fall 1 yard short of getting in the end zone, it's a former defender, you know it hurts.
TJ Hawkinson.
Not only does it hurt, the laughter in film is going to be intense. You are going to get jumped on for not making it all the way to the end zone.
The defense gets him the ball via the turnover. Now can this offense cash in? First and goal. They'll try to run with Hines. And he is in. Touchdown.
Okay. Well, listen to them. 14-0. We are on all Madden. So I wouldn't be talking any of you players who play on rookie difficulty. If we're on rookie difficulty right now, we would be winning like 100-0 already.
And that's exactly what you want, too, because you want to get better each and every week and really ramp up as the season goes on. I know it's still early in the season and a lot can happen. But
okay,
this,
so let's make something happen.
Touchdown ready to kick it away is Sanders. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game.
Dime! Oh, that was the smoothest play ever. That was the smoothest play I've ever had.
This is the NFL on EA Sports.
It says DeAndre Hopkins might be open. See if that's true.
He'll buy
I believe he's gonna be open. Going to the 25? Yeah, 25.
Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29.
Aaron Rodgers got his X factor. Let's go.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers.
Gone!
He's making the catch. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Henry up the middle.
We can't say that if that was on all Madden, that would have been picked, because this is on all Madden, so.
Second and 8. They'll run it again with Henry.
Oh, yeah! Henry! Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
45 yards.
Bull rushing through that line.
And that's the big fella's MO right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. This Carolina defense looking to keep him out of the end zone once more.
This is a risky play here.
Rodgers going to try and run. And he will
yes! Aaron Rodgers! What the heck was that? Did he just hump the air? Bro, what was that?
Partner, wasn't that long ago that when I talk with these NFL coaches about different innovations in the college game, you can see their eyes roll and they just shut down right away. Don't bring me that Joe College stuff. But guess what? The college game has definitely infiltrated its way into the NFL.
Yeah, and so, and these guys, when you're seeing the option defensively, you got to stick.
Matt Gay.
I know that's cliche. They didn't do it there.
And option football means exactly what you just talked about. Assignment football for defenders. And that drives them crazy, because you have to think your way through a play as opposed to just reacting and making the play.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the
okay.
end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it, and afterwards they'll say, there's never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Now Carr. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
They run with Hines, and he'll get this forward only for about a yard, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Working from the gun, it's Carr. That's complete to the receiver, Thielen.
Oh, my gosh!
2-yard line.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Working with the lead, trying to get to 2-0. Here's first and 10. Carr. They'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
To throw again on second down. Carr on the right side, open is Gesicki. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 19.
Come on, defense.
Really nice pick up of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Now Carr again. And this is going to be incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
He'll find Hines out of the backfield.
Let's go.
Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. To throw, it's Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. They only got 2, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it 1st and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there.
Come on.
You can't find your tight end in that
defense
situation.
Come on.
And he's got it.
Oh, my. We need to score a touchdown.
Will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
You could have blocked that kick. I don't pay attention to that stuff.
By Sanders, and it's now 21-7. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with him down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. And that's going to be caught downfield by Mims. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now the Giants will use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half.
Renegade!
On play action, now Rodgers. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback, because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
But one thing's for sure, when you get a big receiver,
one last one. We're shooting for the end zone.
Go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. So we have come to a look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the 3rd quarter. And we will not see a return to start the half, as this will be a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter, perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Oh, it floated on him, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Trayvon Merrick. And the Panthers will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line.
As they started that drive, I think they looked at the scoreboard and said, this is a manageable deficit, guys, but let's go ahead and start cutting it down right here. Instead, an interception happened, so a 2-possession game might become 3.
So as we get going here in the second half,
gotta be joking, man.
Where there isn't enough time left for a comeback if their defense doesn't bail them out.
Come on! Yes! Stop him! Flex on him, boy! Flex! I want to see a flex!
They stay on the ground again. It's Hines. Oh, nice move. And he'll pick up about three there up to the fourth.
Come on! We need this!
Secondary now for the Giants here on third. Set up the screen, it's complete.
Let's go.
Six, he goes and no further, so he is well short of the first down marker. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. As this offense takes the field against
okay.
Last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here.
Hurry up.
And does that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum.
You gotta be joking, me.
Picked off by Trayvon Merrick.
Oh, my.
Bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Well, if there was any thought that this thing might turn around for this offense in the second half, I think those thoughts pretty well dashed after that interception return there.
Yeah, I'm definitely changing it to All-Pro.
There's no other way to say it. They've been overmatched.
Definitely changing it back to All-Pro. Now, you can't change it, like,
contribute to this game getting out of hand
in the middle of the game, but
this will be fielded inside the five. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
On the run, he'll let this
oh, that's picked. Oh, my gosh. Catch the ball.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case,
and we get sacked.
And he goes down. Rogers gonna go on fourth down. And it's
he can't even catch the ball.
And they turn it over. Boy, a real head.
Simmons to the end.
Exciting, this one had a high scoring first half, and nobody let their foot off the gas in the second half either, Charles. And you know, for them, a really nice victory in a high scoring output.
You're right about that, because so many times we'll see teams come out slow and take a while to get going, and points become a little bit harder to score near the end of games, as we know, because everyone tightens down. But no such issues in this game. The scoring started right away and held up in a steady clip the remainder of the game.
So for Carolina, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll return home next week to take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they'll fall to 1-1. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Dallas.
And we're actually versing the Dallas Cowboys. Maybe that's gonna be an easy one for us. Hey, things happen. Things happen. Things happen. But we do have some trade offers, hopefully, and and yeah. See, so David Montgomery. We versus the Dallas Cowboys. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, please make sure to we got Cooper Kupp versus Cooper Kupp. They must have drafted a pretty good team then. Or at least wide receivers. So yeah, we're gonna have to press on their wide receiver on their throwing because they are going to throw a lot since they do have the MVP of last year's Super Bowl. So yeah, hope you guys liked the video. I knew we did take a big L against the Carolina Panthers, but you know, L's happen. You're not gonna have a perfect season. We're not gonna go 17-0. So yeah, guys. Hope you guys liked the video. If you did, make sure to subscribe to the channel and put post notifications on and hit the like button if you want to see more. And I'll see you guys in the next one, which I don't really know what the video is gonna be. It might be a start. It might be a startup. It might be ultimate team. I don't know. It might be a workout video. I don't know. So, yeah, guys. See you in the next one. Peace out. Bye.